We've been talking a lot recently in C# about memory allocation and the stack and the heap and reference types and value types and boxing and unboxing. And I thought, just for a bit of a contrast, we'd look at how those things are done in a different .NET language, which is C++ CLI. Now, C++ CLI is a strange language because it mixes together standard C++, which is a traditional programming language that compiles down to machine code, but then also managed C++, which is a .NET language, which compiles down to intermediate language and therefore gives you the benefits of things like garbage collection and cross-platform compatibility and that sort of thing. Now, C++ CLI isn't used hugely these days, but it can have certain advantages. It can give you the ability to directly interact with the hardware if you want to do that. It can occasionally give you performance benefits, but it's touch and go on that. It always depends on the exact circumstances. But also it can be helpful if you've got a large amount of legacy C++ code that you want to integrate into a .NET system. The disadvantages, however, are it is just vastly complex because it's got all of the .NET side of things plus all of the C++ side of things, and that overall makes it very flexible but very complicated. And it's that contrast, particularly in the area of memory allocation, that I wanted to look at today. So if we take a look at what we've got here, I've just got a console application written in C++ CLI, and I've written a few classes, and the first one we'll look at is this unmanaged class. So this is really just standard C++, and so we create a class, and the thing about the way that C++ works that's different from C# is that in C++, when you write a data type like a class, you are not deciding whether that goes on the heap or the stack. In C#, you either write a class or a struct, and that's what determines where it's going to live. But in C++, you just write a class, and then it's the person who uses the data type that is actually going to make the decision. So more flexible, but more complicated. Just as an aside, it's worth noting in C++, we do have a keyword struct, but it doesn't mean anything related to struct in C#. In C++, when we have a class, that simply means that the default access specifier for this data type is private. So actually that private there is redundant, but I tend to put it in because I think it's easier to read. On the other hand, if we made that a struct, the only difference would be that now if we missed that off, those two members would be public. So it's a reuse of keyword actually in C# that is a bit confusing because we have this distinction between class and struct, but it's a completely different distinction. So in C++, we'll forget about structs. We'll just make that a class. So all we've got is just an unmanaged class. It's some kind of person, I suppose. We've got a name and an age. We've got a constructor. And then this is the way in standard C++ that we can output the data, kind of the equivalent of a toString. And then also we've got what's known as a destructor. And that's simply going to give us a message when the object's destroyed. And so now let's make use of that. So if we go to our main program, and what I'll do is simply declare an unmanaged class, that thing we just had there, so the standard C++ class, call that UC. And then what I'm going to do here is initially I'm going to create this on the stack. And the way we do that is simply we declare it, and then call the constructor. So I'm going to pass in Fred and 37. And that has created it on the stack. And then I could display the output. So I would do that with something like cout, insert UC, insert endl. And when we run that, and we can see it's done the output, Fred 37, that was our output in the insert operator. And then it's also given us that destruction message because this was a stack object, and therefore when it goes out of scope through those curly braces down the bottom there, then it gets destroyed. So that's how we can create a C++ object on the stack. If we want to create it on the heap, then we have to declare it as a pointer. And so we would change that. We'd put a star on there, and then we'd have to say equals new unmanaged class. So similar again to C#, except that to say that it's going on the heap, or strictly speaking to say it's a pointer, we have to use the star, and then that's what allocates it on the heap. And then the other thing we have to do is to get it off the heap, we have to put a star in there. And so if we run that, we get the thread 37 still working, but the thing that you'll notice is missing is we didn't get that call to the destructor outputting that last message. And that's because the heap in unmanaged C++ is not garbage collected. So it doesn't automatically tidy up after itself, and therefore that wasn't called. So that's one of the big issues with C++. We've always got to remember for ourselves to deallocate heap memory explicitly. It's not too difficult to do, not in a simple situation like this. We simply say delete UC at the end of all that, and then when we run that, we'll see that it's making that call. But in complicated programs, getting that delete in the right place and pairing up every new with the delete, even though they may happen hours or days or weeks apart, that's one of the biggest issues that we have in programming C++. But that's all standard C++. Let's move on now and look at the way we can do this in managed C++. And so in managed C++, we have just the same as we have in C#, the ability to have reference types and value types, and that determines on the design of the type where they're going to live. So what I've got here is what I've called a managed reference, and we still declare a class, very similar. We've got a two-string now. We've still got what looks like a destructor, and so that actually, although it looks like a destructor in C++, is the equivalent of our dispose method in C#. But what we do to make this managed is we put the keyword ref on there. So ref for reference. So this is the equivalent of a class in C#. And then the other one I've done, very similar, we've got the managed value. So same sort of thing there, but I've put the keyword value in C++ CLI, which is the equivalent of value class in C++ CLI is the equivalent of a struct in C#. So this is a value type. It's going to live on the stack. But the thing is, in C++, we have this ability, as we saw, to either declare it locally without the star or declare it with the star. And we get the same thing that we can do in C++ CLI with managed objects. So what I could do here is, if I were to say managed reference, now because this is a reference, you'd think I want to put it on the heap, and we do that by putting a little hat on there. So when we want something on the heap in standard C++, we use a star. When we want something on the heap in managed C++, we use the hat, because it's a different heap. They're different places because one of them has garbage collection, one of them doesn't. But apart from that, it's pretty much the same. We could say MR on that, and then equals, and then the other thing we have to do, because we're not putting it on the unmanaged heap, we put another managed heap, we don't use new, we use GC new, which stands for garbage collected new. But then apart from that, it's pretty much the same. Managed reference, pass in Wilma 31, and then we'll use console write line. Note we have to have a double colon rather than a dot in C++. And then I'm just going to pass in MR. That will call the two string. And so when we run this, we'll see that we got that message coming out there. So that's really doing pretty much the equivalent sort of thing that we had with the standard C++. But you'll notice the problem we have there is that the dispose has not been called. Now we could do that directly. We don't call it dispose again. We would say MR arrow and then tilde manage reference. So that would be calling our dispose. And so there you can see we've got the dispose being called. But we know from C sharp that we don't like to do it like that. We don't like to call the dispose directly because there's chances it will get skipped either because an exception's been thrown or simply through bad programming. And so in C sharp, we like to use the using keyword to make this happen automatically. Well, the same thing is available in C++, but with a rather different syntax. And this exploits the trick that we have syntax available to allocate objects in two ways. So if I go back here and change this to what in standard C++ would look like stack allocation. So just say manage reference MR and then directly create it. That looks like stack allocation, but we know it can't be stack allocation because this is a reference type, and in .NET, reference types have to go on the heap. So that is going on the heap. Got to do some slight syntax changes here. So I've got to just explicitly call toString on that one. But then I don't need to call explicitly the dispose the destructor, because now we'll see that that works in the same way, and it's saying disposing of managed reference. And so that's what's happened there. By writing it with this syntax that looks like it's allocating it on the stack, it's still allocating on the heap, but it's allocating it within a using block, which will go out of scope when MR goes out of scope, which will be on that closed curly brace there. So it's exploiting the fact we've got two ways to create an object, not as it does in standard C++ to create them in different places. Both put it on the heap, but one of them puts it in a using block, one of them doesn't. Let's now turn to managed values. So that's what we've got here. That's what we're saying value. And we've got actually the same two ways of creating it. We can create it with a pointer and without, which again seems a bit odd because it's a value type. It should be living on the stack. But let's take a look at that. So back in main, now I'm going to say managed value MV Barney 33. So looks like stack allocation, and it is stack allocation. So that's perfectly straightforward. I can now do my console write line and pass that in there. And so we can see that's working. There's no destruction message come out because this is a value type, and therefore we don't have the idea of a destructor or a dispose, and so there's just nothing there at all. So that's allocation on the stack, as you would expect for a value type. But what about allocation on the heap? Well, we know that in C-sharp terms, if you want to allocate an object, a value type on the heap, then you use boxing. And we've got the same concept in C++. So what I can do is this. I could just say object hat obj equals mv. And that is how we do boxing. So putting into an object, because it's an object on the heap, we've got to use the hat, but that's what we've got. And then we can do things like console write line of obj, and we can see that calls the toString, and so we get the same message out again. But another thing that we can do in C++ CLI, because we can use the pointer syntax with value types, is we can do this. We can say actually managed value hat, and let's call this MVP for managed value pointer. And that is still doing boxing. It has to do boxing for this thing to go on the heap. But what we can't have in C sharp, this is a typed box. So in C sharp, you can only box into an object, but in C++ CLI, you can box into a box of a particular type. And that's what we're doing here. And what that means is that we still have the interface. So I can say MVP arrow, and then I've got a method on there called setAge. So I could say set the age to 50. Now, obviously, what's going on there is we're only changing the value in the box. We're not changing the original value, but it does mean we've had a change. So now if I unbox it, so let's have a managed value unboxed. So no hat there. So this is back on the stack. But what that means is if I now display both the object in the box and the unboxed object, and let's also put in the original object, and we can see the original object is unchanged, but what's in the box has changed to 50, and what we took out of the box has changed to 50. And that's what you couldn't do in C sharp, because we couldn't access what's in the box because it had only got the object type. We could remember in C-sharp, go through any interfaces, but you couldn't access any non-interfaced methods on the object in the box. Whereas here, we are accessing that set age, which is just a regular method, but we can get inside the box. So that's just a quick look at some of the memory features of C++ CLI. And the fact that C++ gives us this syntax of either declaring directly an object or declaring it through a pointer. And when we're dealing with C++ CLI, that's exploited to say when we have a value type, if you declare it through a pointer, that's boxing. And if we have a reference type, and you declare it directly, that is putting it in a using block so that dispose is called. So that was a little bit off track. We've been talking about C-sharp mostly, but I think it's helpful to understand what this does in other languages, what it all means. So I hope you enjoyed that. If you did, click the like button, do subscribe, and I'll see you next time.